Hello everyone, today I will be talking about chiral atom. So, the word chiral itself means the non-superimposable. If you looked at your hand in the mirror, you could see that it cannot be superimposed on each other. Like, if also you looked at a word in the mirror, you usually see it as flipped photo of the word. This comes because of the non-superimposable image that occur in the mirror. Now, for the chiral atom itself, it will be the atom which is attached to four different chemical species. We mean by different species, different groups. This would allow for optical isomerism for the compound, which means it will have an optical activity. Now, if I looked at this example in here, you could see that this is a carbon that is attached from here to hydrogen. From here, it is attached to CH2CH2CHCl. And from here, it is attached to methyl. And from here, it is attached to acyl group. This means this carbon is attached to different four groups surrounding this carbon. This is what will make it a chiral center. If I looked at this carbon, for instance, on the other hand, I could see that this carbon is attached from here to a methyl and here to another methyl. It's also attached to a hidden hydrogen here, and it is attached to CHCl and so on. This will make it a non-chiral because now I have two similar groups attached to the similar carbon atom. If I looked at this carbon, this last carbon in here, I could see that it's attached here to CH, and it is this CH is attached to different CH3, and from here it's attached to CH2, and here it's attached to Cl, and here is a hidden Cl, which will make it a chiral center as well. Now, a chiral would be opposite to chiral, which means it will have no optical activity. Now, if I looked at those examples in here, I have a chiral compound. Because I don't have any chiral atoms, this chiral atoms is not this carbon is not chiral atom because it is attached here to similar groups from both sides. In here, I have two acyl attached to similar carbon, which will make it not chiral as well. But here I have acyl, and here I have methyl, and here I have hydroxyl, which will make this carbon chiral carbon atom. Now, so this is a chiral. This is also chiral compound. Because here I have this carbon attached to chlorine, attached to CH2, then attached to CH, and here I have hidden hydrogen, similar to that with methyl and the hydrogen and CH2 and CH. Now, this compound is not chiral, and this, on the other hand, is a chiral compound, which is similar to this one with a different configuration. Here I have wedged hydroxyl, but here I have dashed hydroxyl. Here is another compound, which is not chiral, because I have here two acyl groups, which are similar from both sides of my structure. This compound is considered to be not chiral as well, because all those groups would be similar from both sides of the carbon, and this one is doesn't have any chiral carbons. And on the other hand, these have two carbon atoms which are chiral, because here I have hydroxyl, and here I have hydrogen, and here I have acyl, and here I have CHCl. So this compound should be chiral because I have two chiral carbon atoms. Let's look at this question, and this question from Organic Chemistry 7th edition for Brown and Everson. Now, which compound contains a chiral center? So first, 2-chloro-pentane. So I need to draw down the structure, then decide if it have any chiral carbon atom, it will be a chiral compound. If it doesn't have any chiral carbon atom, it will be unchiral. Now I have chloro-pentane. So I have five carbon atoms, 1, 2, 3, 4, and here I have 5, and this one would be attached to hydrogens, and this is attached to another to hydrogen from here, but because I have 2 chloro, so this one would be Cl, and here I will have hydrogens at the rest of my structure. If you looked at this carbon, it's attached here to CH3, then in here it is attached to CH2CH2CH3, which will make this carbon, in that case, a chiral carbon atom, and this compound is a chiral compound. Now, 3-chloro-pentane, in that case, I have the I will have the chlorine atom attached in the middle, and here I will have hydrogens, just let's indicate it as dash, and you could see that this carbon is attached here to CH2, CH3. And from this side is attached also to CH2, CH3. So because they are similar groups on both sides of my carbon, this compound is a chiral compound. Now if I look at this example, I have 3-chloro-1-pentene. So I have double bond, and that case would be in the first position. So I have CH2, CH. Then I have C attached to two hydrogens. So 1, 2, 3, then 4. And here I have this attached to 5. At the position number 3, I would have a chlorine atom. So this carbon, if you could look at this one, it's attached to CH2, CH3. And in here, CH, CH2. And from this side, then it's attached here to hydrogen. This is the hydrogen. And here, Cl. So you could see there are different groups on both sides of my compound, which will make it a chiral. Chiral compound, and contains this chiral carbon atom, this asterisk indicating this carbon atom. And here I have 1 and 2 dichlorobromane, so I have 5 carbon atoms. And at the position 1, I will have chlorine atom and a chlorine atom at the position number 2, and here I will have hydrogen, hydrogen, and hydrogen. Here I have also hydrogens. And let's look at this carbon. In here, it is attached to CH3, then it is attached to CH2, and so on. And here Cl, and here H, which will make it a chiral carbon atom. Let's look at this carbon. So this carbon is attached to two hydrogens. So from both sides, same groups or same atoms, this will make it not chiral. So this one is not chiral, and this only carbon is a chiral carbon atom, which will make this compound chiral compound. By that, we came to the end of the video. Thank you and goodbye.